Bintum, bintum, bum, 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 ba do 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 do. Bum, 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 ba dum dum dum. Dum dum dum. A do 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 do. Bum, 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 ba dum dum dum. Up in the morning, 6 o'clock. Head for the city. Ba do 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 do. Turn on the music, the radio. Nobody's hurrying, nobody's hurrying. Day after day, ooh, 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 slaving away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Punching the time, I'm late again. Sneak in the back way, ba doo 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 doo. I count the hours, minutes two. So glad it's Friday, so glad it's Friday. Jump in the ride. Ooh, 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 it's Friday night. Yeah, 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 yeah. Living it up, oh yeah. Friday night. Living it up at last. Living it up, oh yeah. A Friday night. Living it up at last. Woo, guys, it is Friday. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh yeah, man, it's Friday. You know, Silver 5150 here on the 5150 channel. It's Friday. You know, you put in a good hard week this week, right? You know, you put in a good hard week this week. But the law, the government says you can't go out and party. All of the bars are closed. There's no place to go. So what are you going to do? You're going to have to try to find a party. You're going to try to create a party. You need some party animals to get things going. And who do we have tonight? The usual suspects, troublemakers. The Czech Line from the Czech Republic. This is the 2018 version. All right, that's the backside of that. And of course, the big troublemaker is the American Silver Eagle. Tell you what, one of the straight up just troublemaking party animals, swing off of the lampshade, swing off of the chandeliers, and get caught up in the ceiling fan. This is the American Silver Eagle. This is the troublemaker. All right. And even when he brings a girl along, still doesn't behave himself. All right, other side of that. Right here, you know what? Let's be honest. Let's just be straight up. First and foremost, if you're going to end up going somewhere, you're going to need some designated drivers. Now, these guys here, the Puffins, they can't hold any alcohol at all. In fact, you know, if you just kind of stick the bottle up to their nose, they'll fall right over. But best damn drivers you ever had. Okay? So, this is the 2019 Alderney Puffin. It's a very, very nice coin. 25,000 minted, and the Apmex Mint Direct Premier makes it even more exclusive. We don't know how exclusive. All we know is that when you sell back to Apmex, they don't give you, like, the exclusive price. They just treat it like regular bullion. I think I'm smelling a scam here. Anyway, so, on to the hangers-on. So these guys right here, the Buffaloes. Buffalo! Buffaloes, man, they just like to hang in the party. They hang around in the background and stuff. They wink at girls and kind of bop around and stuff. But they don't really cause any trouble, right? But they're not really goody two-shoes either. You get in a fight, they got your back, all right? See what I'm saying? All right, and here we have the Chaperones. The Chaperones from John Wick. These are part of the assassin sect. And these guys right here, they're actually security. You know, people say the Chaperones, you're actually security. You gotta have security in your group and stuff. So they hang out with the hangers-on. They hang out with the mingle in the medium crowd and in the regular crowd. And then over here are the dragons. These are the Xiangnan province dragons. These are the ones I told you that, well, they're very expensive. And in fact, they find the most expensive drinks when you go to the bar, and they make you buy them because they don't have a tab themselves. In fact, they don't ever bring any money because they are the money. Yes, the Xinjiang, this is a Chinese restrike Providence Dragon, and its thing is just on the money because it is the money. And now on to the Goody Two Shoes 2018 Jubilee Elephants from the Somali Republic. And these guys right here, they're big. They're partiers, but they really don't want any trouble at all. And in fact, if a place looks like trouble, they'll try to talk you out of going because that's just not their thing. They want to go where they can have a good time, just kind of chill and mellow. Maybe listen to some trance music and just hang out there. You know, maybe if there's a hookah around, you know, they'll stick their snout in there, get some smoke. I don't know. They're just not really big party animals, but they will hang with the party as long as they feel they're going to be safe. No mice involved, right? No mice allowed. All right, so. And here, we have even more safety-conscious partiers, more of the goody-two-shoes, the Congo Giraffe from 2019, the Republic of Congo. This is a proof coin. This is a proof coin that was sold last year at a bullion price, and a very good price at that, 30,000 minted, I believe. Nope, 50. 50,000 minutes, same as the gorillas from the Congo. And it has a different back to it compared to the other Congo coins. But that's okay, because they're goodies. And goodies can change like that from time to time. Okay, next up. And finally, wait a minute. You're thinking, well, wait a minute. These guys are snakes. Why they get to be with the goody two-shoes? Because, guys, snakes get a bad rap. They're always expected to be the bad guys. They're always expected to be the ones that's going to cause the problems and stuff. Look at the Slytherin house in Harry Potter. You know, they didn't get fair billing at all, man. It was like, oh, it must be them because they're dark and they're kind of weird and, you know, they're kind of gothic. They listen to Marcy and they can't be trusted. No, these are the good guys. Yes, these right here, these are the Goody Two Shoes, the 2013 Year of the Snake. From the Perth Mint, this is a lunar coin from Perth Mint, and you can still get these things all over the place. Every once in a while, Provident will have a good sale where they're selling for like $23. I don't know if that's going to happen again, but even if you can get these for under $30, for a 7-year-old lunar coin, man, it is not a bad deal. Not a bad deal at all. And you notice how much bigger they are than, say, some of the regular bullion coins. Even the Silver Eagle that has a pretty wide spread to it is small compared to the 1-ounce lunar coin. Now, maybe it's the capsule. I don't think so. It's actually a pretty big coin, which means it's probably pretty thin and pretty flat, all right? Regardless, they can drink a lot. Yes, the snakes. Why? Because their body's so long and it takes them a long time to get hammered. Okay, so we've got our party animals. We've got the designated drivers. We've got the troublemakers, obviously. And we've got the hangers-on, the middle of the road crowd with our hidden security inside, right? And then we've got the goody two-shoes. So guys, we're ready to roll. So you figure you get off work and you find that one person at work that wants to basically start a party at work, you know, and you're thinking like, no, Eagle, we're not going to do that. We're not going to start a party at work because that's how a lot of us get in trouble. And you know what happened last time? Okay. Yeah. Somebody got pregnant. Not cool. Anyway. So then, you know, the Lions over here says, okay, well, you know what? Let's go ahead and have a party, but let's have a party at your house since you are so inclined to have a party. And Eagle's like, okay. So everybody goes over to the Eagle's house to have a party. And now, you know, the drinks are floating around and stuff, and you know, got a punch bowl going. You know, the pool is open in the back, and the music's playing and stuff, and everybody's having a really good time. And, you know, people start to get a little tipsy and everything like that. And then the Eagles sing like, well, this is a great party, but you know what would be really great? Let's go see if we can find some other parties. And everybody's like, well, I don't know. Is it the Goody Two-Shoes? Like, I don't know. I just, maybe it's like, you know, Mill Road guys. Like, I don't care. You know, yeah, we got drivers, so why not? You know, let's just go to this. Watermelon Callum, Watermelon Callum. By the way, Watermelon Cantaloupe is the sound of a lot of people talking at one time. Watermelon Callum, Watermelon Callum, Watermelon Callum. Okay, all right, guys, let's go. And if you like me, here, the Eagles have a really, really big vehicle. I've got a 2019 Toyota Sequoia that seats 8 comfortably. And, seven comfortably, and that's enough to get the posse down the street, because if you try hard enough, you can get everybody inside. So you want a big ride, so you can take your big posse down the street and find another party, and you end up going to some friends of the Lions that have a nice house party going. It was better than the one that was over at Eagle's house, and so you're here at this house party, and man, the thing gets rowdy quick, all right? The thing gets rowdy quick. You're in there, you're partying and everything, and everybody's getting lit and getting drunk and stuff, and people starting to talk trash, and the card games are going, and the dominoes are smacking, and everything, and somebody gets a bright idea. You know, it would really be great. It'd be really great if we go to that block party I heard about down there on 3rd Street. And everybody's like, what? And the next day, the driver's like, no, we don't want to do it anymore. And the Goody Two-Shoes is like, I don't think that's a good idea. Yeah, what if we're not invited? Yeah, what if security quits on us? Well, the thing is, it's going to be a good time because it's a block party. When you show up at a block party, nobody knows if you're supposed to be there or not. Just act like you're supposed to be there. Just act like you're supposed to be there and go. All right? So everybody gets into the ride again. Now we got extra people, and we go to the block party. You get to the block party, man, and now everybody's kind of chilled out. Everybody's found their niche. Even the troublemakers and stuff, they found some other troublemakers to fight with, you know, a little bit. So they do a little friendly street fighting there. You know, no big deal. Nobody's getting up in the hospital. A couple of missing teeth and stuff like that. Designated drivers are still in the car. They want nothing to do with it. They're just sitting there, and they're trying to eat their Subway footlongs and, you know, just pretending that's not going on. Little road guys are having a great time. You know, they're dancing, and they're meeting new people, and they're having fun. Dragon can tell jokes and do a couple of magic tricks and stuff, so you know that's a real party stopper right there, and everybody's having a good time, and even the Goody Two Shoes in the back. Turns out that the Jubilee Elephant is not just a heavy drinker, but actually has found its limit at this block party and has started dancing.
decided that it could dance not just in the street, but on any tabletops it can find itself climbing on top of, which would be none, which means all of them got broken, which means somebody called the cops. Okay, somebody called the cops, and Goody Two Shoes Giraffe's like, oh no, I think I hear the cops coming. Everybody's like, the snake's like, well, I'll tell you what, I'm just gonna pretend like I'm a light pole, and I ain't gonna get caught by the cops, okay? You forget that. That's not my bag, all right? But guess what? This entire thing was orchestrated not by the eagle, right? And not by the lions, because the real party man, the real party goer, the real party starter is the Monkey King. That's right, the Monkey King. This is a 2016 coin out of the Perth Mint. It is a lunar coin, a lunar gold coin. I've got some 5-ounce silver ones, but they're at the vault. But these are the 2016 Lunar Monkey King coins. And the Monkey King, guys, if you ever follow any of my videos, you know he is the party starter, the party stopper, the party creator. He is the party. He is the life of the party. He is the Monkey King. And he is the ringleader of all of this right here. A lot of people don't even know. Everybody thought Eagle initiated everything. Monkey King came by the office early that morning and says, hey, man, I heard you having a party at your house. Eagle's like, well, I don't remember. Like, no, you said it. You said it a couple weeks ago. You're about, I did? Yeah, you did. He said, fine, okay. So that's how it all started. But the Monkey King happens to be brothers with the mayor, and so nobody gets in a lot of trouble. Everybody gets spoke to by the cops. The designated drivers are standing up with the doors open. These guys are trying to talk their way out of it. They're like, well, officer, it wasn't me. We would never do nothing like that, with a couple of missing teeth and the bloody nose and stuff, and sitting there and like scratching their head. No, they're in trouble. No, they're wrong. And so the middle of the road guys, they're just kind of slowly, you know, going by, giving their information, because you got to do that these days. There's a card trick on the way to the car. The cops don't like it, so everybody moves out smartly and gets back in the ride and takes off. Yes, and the party has to go back to the house. So we go back to the house now. We're back at Eagle's house. You know, these people, their friends have gone home. We're back at Eagle's house. Everybody's partying and stuff. And we get back to the party, and they realize there is no booze. There's no alcohol. What the hell? And everybody's thinking, man, what a bummer, because this could have really, really capped off the night. Great Monkey King says, do not worry. I found a limousine company that will actually send their cars here. And everybody's like, watermelon cantaloupe, watermelon cantaloupe, what the hell are you having the cars come? We're not going to go anywhere else. We already went out for the night. He's like, no, you don't understand. Even though there's no alcohol and no stores are open and nothing is out there to drink, limousines have their own bars. Ooh, I think I see what's going on here. There's a watermelon cantaloupe, watermelon cantaloupe. That's right. The only problem is they cost $1,400 per car per night. Oh, no, it's got $1,400. Oh, yeah, you know, now that I think about it, I've got some silver, and the silver eagles I have are worth about $1,400 a piece. I wonder if they take silver. Hang on a second. Yeah, Monkey King here. You take silver? Oh, you love silver. Okay, great. We got silver. Bring them over. And the cars come over, and the Monkey King is the hero of the night. Inside the cars are all kinds of booze, all kinds of craziness. And so the party goes on all through the night, and then without any warning, people just fade out, and the party's over and stuff. And now it's the next morning. The limos are sitting outside. The doors are still open. The bars are empty, right? And everybody's sprawled around the house. They're just, you know, laid out everywhere. You know, I think Giraffe has accidentally got half its face stuck in the pool. Somebody has to pull, you know, its face out so it doesn't drown and stuff. And then the snake is, you know, sprawled out across the clothesline because he thought it was a hot chick. And so, you know, he's kind of laying there. And people start waking up. And of course, you know, the Monkey King, who is actually the instigator, who is actually the party starter, right, does not drink, does not smoke, and starts waking everybody. Oh my gosh, I just realized I'm the Monkey King. I love to party. I love to start things and get things started and really stir it up and get, like, make one for the ages, man. A real, real humdinger, just a party that's for the ages, man. One that you barely get out alive of. But I'm not a drinker or a smoker myself. I just love to party. Oh my gosh. Anyway, so everybody's laying around. They're trying to figure themselves out and stuff. And, you know, and taking their finger, tying up their nose, and figuring they're going to take a shower and stuff. And the Monkey King walks in with a big old apron on and says, would anyone love pancakes? A lot of you guys aren't going to get that inside baseball. That is a joke and a tribute to Prince, who was an excellent cook. Prince, the pop star, was an excellent cook and, of course, an excellent musician. But, you know, when people came over to his house and they partied too long, he would make them breakfast the next morning. That was Prince's thing. Or he'd meet them for coffee down in Minneapolis somewhere. Anyway, so
Lucky King makes everybody breakfast, and people start sobering up and cleaning up and stuff, and it is one, like I said, for the ages. That was it, guys. That was our night partying with the animals, man. Partying with the animals. Partying with the party animals. Who do we got? We got the designated drivers. The at Mex Met the Wrecked Alderney 2019 Puffins. Let's go ahead and straighten it out there. And we've got the 2018 Czech Lions, right? Because I like that design best, all right? 2018 Czech Lions. We've got the 2014 American Silver Eagles, okay? For 2019, we got the Silvertown Buffaloes, all right? Love these. And in 2019, we also have the John Wick, John Wick silver coins from the Assassin's Guild. And we have over here the 2018 Chinese Restrike Qiangnong Province dragon coins. Then here we have the 2018 Somali Jubilee Elephants, right? 2019 Congo Giraffes, and the 2013 Year of the Snake Lunar Coin from the Perth Mint. And man, what a party bunch this is. Well, guys, we're going to sign off for this week, man. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for all the new subs and stuff. And I just want to say a couple of things before I leave. And it's just an idea about how we are going to benefit from all this stacking and all these efforts we're making. There are going to be some devaluations and revaluations coming towards us as we start to get out of the dollar into whatever's next. I hear a lot of comments about guys saying, you know, just forget all this metal stuff, going to crypto. I hear a lot of people saying, well, they're never going to get rid of the dollar. They're just going to make a new dollar, or they have a new currency. I don't care if it's going to be the Amero. I don't care if it's going to be the Fed coin or a crypto-backed dollar. I don't care if it's going to be a strategic drawing right like they have at the International Monetary Fund, the IMF. I don't care what it's going to be. No matter what kind of contortions, they could go through five variations in 2 years. And whatever they do in that vein, it's going to damage people. It's going to hurt people a lot. Whenever they decide they want to change the valuation on a currency or the type of currency when they go to fix the world currencies, it's going to hurt people. Whoever gets into the new currency and then they have to bounce out into something else, they're going to lose a tremendous amount of wealth and a tremendous amount of purchasing power during that time. This gold and silver is the only vehicle that can change and stay fluid with what whatever kind of revaluations they want to do, whatever kind of changes they want to do with the currency. You could go through, if you have enough metal, you could go through four or five revaluations and still come out in position to function in whatever the final iteration of the global economy is. Okay, and if you need a good example of that, just look up Russia and hyperinflation during the 19-teens into 1923, from 1917 to 1923, Russia from 1917 to 1923, and Russia later on in, I believe, 1998. And that's a good example. Zimbabwe is always a good example. Weimar Republic in 1923 is always a good example of what can happen when there's just one currency revaluation. Just one. The hyperinflation that they went through, they just changed either the mark, the Reichsmark, or the ruble, or the Zimbabwe dollar once. And that was it. And, I mean, it just blew everybody, you know, away, and it's just ruined everybody, okay? But with gold and silver by your side, you can go through any revaluations they have. All right. And I know we're going through economic turmoil right now with the markets gyrating all over the place and stuff like that. But I can tell you right now, whatever we're experiencing as far as deflation in this current climate is an ant compared to the 800-pound gorilla in a room that's going to be multiple currency devaluations in a short period of time later on. All right. So what do you do, man? What do? You do exactly what we're doing right now. And you don't keep the good news to yourself. You know, Christ says, preach the good news. Go out to the world and preach good news. Well, the good news when it comes to the economy is that you can turn a tragedy into your new, reality. You can turn that tragedy into a really, really nice bit of prosperity by having gold and silver. It's the only thing I do. Buy the gold and silver, hold it, and wait. And in fact, when the revaluations takes place, just sit and wait through those. You can watch them and you go, ooh, man, that kind of hurt. But you know what? We're fine. And that's what you want to do. So currency devaluations and revaluations, I think, are going to be completely bonkers once they start going. People won't know what to make of them. You'll be hearing one thing on news Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. It'll change from day to day. And then people will come out on the other side realizing they don't have anything, not even shirts on their backs. All right? So spread the good news. We talk to each other all the time. I was issued a challenge today by Silver Game of Thrones to top a 100-plus ounce order he had coming in. Well, Silver Game of Thrones, I take your challenge, sir, and I call you. Oh, wait, I can't do that.
I'll just pass it along to someone else, like Silver Joker. You hear that, Silver Joker? I'm coming for you. You're going to have to place a big order, and you have to unbox it in front of everybody. Guys, I love this community. I love this movement we're on, this challenge, this wave that we're creating. It is happening. We are the next monetary system. We are the next wealth cycle. It is some awesome, awesome stuff to behold. I'm watching it grow day by day, and it just really, really fulfills me. So thank you guys for joining me here at the Silver 5150 channel. On Friday, it's time to get out there and party, however you can do it. This weekend, blow off some steam, because God knows it's built up all week. All right? Like, share, subscribe, comment. Oh, and hit that bell that says all, by the way, if you want to see any more of my new videos. Because here at the Silver 5150 channel, we are pie in the sky. We are irrationally exuberant. We are very, very positive about what's going to happen, because we know it's going to be all good, right? Because it's God's money, and he wants what's best for us. That's the way it is. He's the man. He called it. And we're going to do what we need to do to get to the other side. Amen. All right, guys. Take care.